two Newton coasters, a physics learning kits, final presentation on our product. We are Team 22. I'm Luke Woodward.
I'm Kylo Osman.
I'm Luke Soyu.
During this presentation, we will go over the main features of our project, which would be the mission statement, the economics for the product, our concept generation, and how we got to the final product itself, and a discussion of future changes to our product.
We believe that our mission statement have a significant impact on our BRG project when compared to the other parts of the project. The most important part that we believe in is the key business goals and the primary market. These two characteristics play huge roles when we decide to design our BRG and market our product. In order to achieve control of 50% of the market in the next 3 years, dominate the market within the next 5 years, and to improve the product every year, we have to sell as many our product as we can in the next few years. We have to make our product different from the competitors. So our key business goal is directly related to the industrial design, which is here, where we place huge importance on the product differentiation. When our product varied than the competitor's product, our product is stand up from the rest, and hopefully we can attract as many potential customers as we can. On top of that, we try to decrease the cost of the product so that more people can buy our product. Our prime market is students and teachers. We place this in our mind when we design our BRG. When we assemble our BRG, it's under a minute. So we believe that the time taken to assemble the BRG can be used in the classroom, as it doesn't affect the teaching material in the class. On top of that, our BRG is durable, as the users is high school student and they may be rough on the parts. So they don't have to worry about buying a new one or changing a different part. On top of that, our BRG is in a model form, so when one part is broken, they don't have to buy the new entire set to replace the new BRG. On top of that, our BRG can evolve and vary as time went on, as more station is coming out in the next few years.
For the economics, we previously talked about our model of price of product, and we have the break-even point at 172 units, and we have our maximum profit at 18,500 when we sell 700 units. And we have talked about the investment proposal. In the proposal, if we have interest rate of 12% and the initial investment of 20,000, we would have 2056 each quarter after the ending of the first year. And for the DP3, we added assembly time worksheet. From the worksheet, we can see the actual total assembly time is about 1 minute, and it takes no more than 8 minutes to assemble the whole part for all the users. And this proves the BRG to be easy and acceptable to use in high school classrooms. And we also added cost sheets this time. For our cost sheet, it's based on our real prototype, and the price are estimated based on of the market value of the individual part. And we also assume that if we use mold to make the part, we can manufacture each part with a cheaper cost.
The next thing that we would like to talk about is concept generation. And there are three main components to our product, and those are the three stations. And each station covers a different concept in physics. And the concepts we decided to go for this product were projectile motion, electrical analysis, and momentum. And for station one, which covers projectile motion, we went with this concept here, which and the reasoning why we went with this station was it dealt with a spring, which allowed for a relatively easy way to launch the ball into the next station. It also had an adjustable ramp. This ramp could be changed by the user, allowing for different angles at which the ball can be launched, thus having different trajectories that it will follow. And this would allow the students to further understand how projectile motion works, how different angles affect the distance it travels, and the way the ball travels. The next station dealt with electrical analysis. And for this station, instead of going with a circuit build, we went with a simple Arduino build. So the reason why we went with Arduino instead of a circuit was circuit, you had to deal with different resistors, voltages, things can go wrong. We didn't want to have to deal with any of that. So what we did was we took an Arduino, we set it up so it would ask the user a series of questions, and if the user got above 80% of the questions right, it would allow the gate that holds the ball in station 2 to release, thus allowing the ball to travel down and into the next station. The next station dealt with momentum, and in this station, we went with a relatively simple design of having a simple ramp that would allow a mass ball to roll down, thus hitting the ping pong ball. The reason why we went with this was it was the simple ramp, obviously, and then the ability to have the user use some of the balls that we provided, or to have the user bring any other type of ball or material along with them and see how that works with momentum. And once the ball rolled down, it would hit the ping pong ball, roll into the finish, and it would finish. Right here is our finished product. As you can see right here, this is station one. And instead of using a spring, we went with a more reliable and easier to fix method, was a rubber band. This allowed for the user to easily launch the ball, and thus if it was to break, they could easily just get another rubber band, either provided or from any store, and replace it. Next we have station 2 over here. And station 2, there was relatively no changes since the concept generation. It uses the Arduino, as seen right there, to release the ball into the next station here. The last station, which deals with momentum, has the ball end up here, and the user inputs another ball at the top of this ramp, allowing the ball to roll down, hitting the ping pong ball, releasing it into the finish. The last thing that we would like to talk about is future changes to our product. There are several changes we would like to make in our future installments of the product. One being to add new stations that would cover a variety of different topics other than physics. That could be chemistry, it could be biology, anything in the STEM field that we feel like it would benefit the teachers and the students in learning the material. The next thing we would like to do is add more reliable connections to each of the stations. And this is because even though the connections we have to each station right now are within our standards, we would like to have a more flawless run with each go, allowing the user to have the stations move smoothly and allow for less error when they're learning the material. The next thing we would like to do would be add an increased number of stations for each product. The product itself being modular allows for the entire project itself to have interchangeable parts. In the future, we'd like to have more stations within the same product, allowing the user to learn more concepts at once, allow for the teacher to teach more concepts at once, and have an overall better learning experience with the topic they're learning. And the last thing we would like to do is we would like to improve the overall quality of our product. We would like to, as we have future installments of our product, increase the overall quality, thus making the user want to go back to our product each time we change and improve it. And that is our presentation. Thank you for your time, and have fun learning.